This is something that interests me. You do, for example, you do a tremendous Johnny Carson. Are all of your guys going to die off pretty soon? I mean, you've got, is that a concern? Because one of the things about our life now with all these TV channels out there, there's so little commonality.
Yeah.
You know, the classic impressions when we were coming up, you know, was Edward G. Robinson when we were little kids. We're
right.
Like, who the hell's that?
Yeah.
And now you've got people in their 30s going, Johnny, who?
Well, that's why I had to bring along Christopher Walken.
There you go.
For the kids who love him. I'm a huffer at heart. I don't know if you saw the Fat Boy Slim video, but I kick it old school.
That's great.
Have you interviewed Christopher Walken?
No. No.
Okay, well, here's your chance. And keep in mind, all of his thoughts are completely unconnected. So go ahead and ask Christopher Walken anything.
All right, what's your new project, Christopher?
Frankenstein never scared me.
So how long have you been working on the film?
Marsupials do.
And when's its release date?
Because they're fast.
They are fast. Christy, do you want to handle the questions? You can ask them about it.
But you have to remember that all of his thoughts are completely unconnected.
Yeah, therefore, any question you ask, it doesn't matter.
That's right.
You can't go wrong here.
Good morning.
Mr. Walken, how are you today?
Hi. Picasso was a hack.
I can't help but notice you've done some wonderful films, but you're also quite the dancer.
I kick it old school. I'm a hoofer at heart, but truth is, I don't wear shoes.
Let's talk about your latest project. Do you have a movie coming out soon?
Peanuts in a bag. Wow.
Okay. Are you a sports fan?
Baby poo everywhere. It's crazy. You know, he recently...
Peanuts in a bag! Wow!
He recently had his feet and hands and signature put in cement in front of the famous...
Chinese theater.
Theater in Los Angeles. And they don't really do that anymore. You can get the star in the Walk of Fame, but... They kind of stopped doing the feet and the cement because there's only so many squares out front.
Yeah.
And I got a call. My office called and said, you know, they're going to do this for Christopher Walken. It's a really big deal. And he would like you to be one of the two people who speaks at this ceremony. I was, you know, flattered beyond belief, but I'd only met him once, very briefly, in passing. I don't know if I mentioned that. That story before, but I went to visit Barry Levinson on the set of this movie, and Christopher Walken was there, and I did the impression for Barry, and Barry laughed and said, "You got to meet him." And so I met him, and Barry, he said, "Chris, this is Kevin Pollak." "Oh, hey, been a while. How are you?" We had never met. And I, of course, said, "It's good to see you again."
Absolutely.
Yeah. And so I get this call, and it's like, why? Yes, of course. I'm flattered. I'm honored. But
I don't know the guy.
How many people fell out? What?
Where am I on the list?
Yeah. You know, I just who could pass up this opportunity? So it was Quentin Tarantino and me. You know, and Quentin, of course, directed in Pulp Fiction and wrote the great scene in True Romance that he does with Dennis Hopper. So they have a wonderful connection, you know. And I'm just thinking, what are you doing here? This is odd. And I would say, you know, that's funny coming from you. But anything's odd. So I show up and he big smile and hug, you know. They told me you might be and this is exciting. And I thought, oh, please, this can't be the exciting part of the day. Because, again, getting your hands and feet in the cement is something they started in, what, the 30s? I mean, yep. This is a really big deal. And so I kept saying that to him. This is a really big deal, isn't it? And he said, it is. It's crazy. I wanted to call my mom, but I don't want to kill her. She's 96. She died dead away. I know it. Ma, I'm in cement. Boom, dead. I don't need that. You know, I want to get the call. Your mother's dead. I want to make the call.
So I
just went up there and I said to the press and the crowd that had gathered, you know, and this stage is built right before he's going to put his hands at them. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, they introduced me to speak, and I walk up and I say, well, you know, as an actor, everyone's dream, I suppose, is to be unique and original, and certainly we honor one today. In fact, I'm here, I guess, representing the thousands and thousands of people who try to steal Christopher's magic every day by doing an impression mm-hmm. of him, you know. And then my favorite time is Halloween, you know, where the kids come to the door and I answer it. And they come to the door to get the candy and I answer it as Christopher Walken, you know. Trick or treat? Good question. I, too, have a question. Which one of you kids can guess what I've buried under the house? And I hear him laughing behind me. This is the first time I've ever done the impression in front of him. I mean, I've done it on Conan O'Brien, and then Conan had Walken on the show and showed him clips of like five of us doing him. So I knew he saw it, and I'd only assume that's how I got invited to this thing. But to hear him bent over in hysterics right behind me, having watched me do this, was surreal and maybe the greatest moment ever. Yeah, and that's just great. And then afterwards. And so we're sitting down for lunch, and someone says, "You know, a lot of people do an impression of you, Chris. You know, and that must be weird. You know." And then someone else says, "Yeah, but who does the best?" You know, and he says, with a little, tiny Cheshire grin, says, "Gavin, of course." And I'm sitting next to him, thinking, "What else is he?"